Good morning and happy Sabbath, Central Islip. Amen. Mercy, we're gathered here few in numbers today, but where two or three are gathered, amen, God is here and dwells in their presence, amen. But we're going to do as we do every week. We're going to stand on our feet as we usher in the presence of God and the platform party as we sing welcome to this place. Church, let's the voice and say, welcome, say. It says, rejoice, people of God. This is our Sabbath day. Rejoice, friend in Christ. This is our time for worship. God ordained the Sabbath, rest and restoration. God is worthy of worship. Our creator, healer, and inspiration. So then, let us worship God. We gather today to worship the one who created us, the one who called us, the one who equipped us, the one who loves us without end. With joyful heart, let us worship God. Amen. Let us read the affirmation. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord bless the Sabbath day and hallowed it. The church is now called to worship. Let's lift our voice and sing praise.
Praise God from all. us unite in prayer. Dear God, we thank you for what you have done. 6 days pass. Here we come to praise you. Here we come to glorify your name, for there is none like you. Angels bow before you. Here we are in Centria, High Slip. We come to praise you. So let the words of our mouth and our worship today be acceptable in your sight, and we'll be careful to give you all the praise. Let the church say, amen.
Good morning, happy Sabbath, church. Do we have any visitors in our midst today? Yes, please. Can you please stand and let us know where you're from? Introduce yourself, please. Amen. Amen. We welcome you into our midst today. This is a friendly church where we love everybody. You're only a visitor once. Next time, you're family. So please come back and worship with us when you're in the area. Amen. You're welcome. I'll do your announcements at this time. Welcome everybody who, if you're worshiping on Zoom or in-house or across the hall in the children's church, we welcome everybody to our services today. Join us on Zoom every day at 5:30 a.m., 12:30 p.m., and 7:30 p.m. Friday sunsets. The Zoom information ID numbers are in your bulletins. The youth department is planning a back-to-school backpack drive. On August 7th, they are asking for at least 2 backpacks from each member. If you can donate them, that would be greatly appreciated. And the Long Island Area Evangelism Council would like to meet with all board members Sunday at 7 p.m. to discuss matters on the upcoming crusade. That Long Island crusade will be being held August 6th in Westbury, 992 Prospect Avenue in Westbury. If anybody is interested in being an usher at these services throughout the 4 weeks, please let us know. Sign up, there's still time to sign up for the 30-day Daniel Diet Program. You can see Elder McGinnis or Sister Karen Stoddart for more information with that. So, we will be having our baptism service with Pastor Edward Jackson on July 23rd. It will be held during our 11 o'clock church service. And then in our bulletin, we have happy graduation. We have Anna Hendricks. She's graduated from Central Islip High School. Amen. We have Jaden Bandu. She graduated from Central Islip High School. We have Nayala Marsh. She also graduated from Central Islip High School. And we also have Raymond Wilson. He graduated from Stony Brook University. Amen. Let's give them all a hand. Amen. 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 Great work. Our graduation and Christian Education Day is going to be August 6th. And our women's retreat coming up in November, November 4th through the 6th. There's still time for early registration. The Long Island Evangelism Planning Meeting will be held tomorrow, Sunday, July 19th at 7 p.m. And the Zoom ID is July 17th, excuse me. And also, we have summer team camp. Northeastern Conference Adventist Academy is hosting a summer STEAM camp. STEM, excuse me. And this is going to be July 18th through the 28th. And the hours are going to be 9 to 1. And this is going to be at Bethesda Church, 76 Parkway Avenue in Amityville. Those who are interested, there is on this flyer, we have the QR code and also any other announcements. I said that. We have the QR code is out in the lobby that you can scan with your phone for other information that's happening. And also we're going to be having the New Beginnings Hope, Healing, and Happiness service. This will be on August 6th through September 3rd. And that will be at 992 Prospect Avenue in Westbury. And again, I just wanted to reemphasize the baptism that will be taking place on July 23rd, 11 o'clock service here at Central Islip. Sunset today is at 8:22 and next Friday at 8:17. These are your announcements. Thank you for listening and participating. Thank you.
Happy Sabbath. It looks as if we all look quiet. Wake up, wake up. We are in the house of the Lord, right? David says something. He says, rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord, my soul. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord, my soul. Praise him. Hallelujah. Praise him. Hosanna. Praise him. Hallelujah. All my sins are taken away. All my trials, he is the bearer. My sorrow, he is the bearer. My sickness, he is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Our God is able, so we have to rejoice in him. We have to cast away all burdens because we are in the hands of great, mighty God. So let us rejoice and be glad in him. Amen. Let's stand up and turn our hymn books 518, our opening hymn. It says, standing on the promises of Christ my King. In the bulletin, page 6. Standing on the promises of Christ, my King, through eternal ages, let his praise be spread. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises. promises of God, my Savior, standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear I slay, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises of Christ the Lord. Bound to him in turning by life's strong cord, overcoming daily with the spirit's sword, standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Hallelujah.
It's praise and worship time, man. How many people came today just to lift your hands in worship and adoration and just, because we serve a mighty God, amen? One who reigns over everything. He sits high and he looks low. No matter how far you've gone, no matter what you've done, he still can reach out and grab you and save you and clean you up and flip you around and get you on the right track. Amen. Keeps you in a nice sound mind. Amen. And we worship him. And I always say it, I probably say it every Sabbath, we don't worship him for just what he's done, but we worship him for what? For who he is. Go ahead, Tim. You can start playing. You don't wait on. And we love him because he first loves us. So we're just going to sing this worship song, this little love song, and use your sanctified imagination and picture God just listening to your worship as you sing, because I said before, if God had a weakness, his weakness would be for worship. Amen. The song goes like this. It says, God Almighty, Lord of glory, Lord, God Almighty, Lord of glory, Lord, we worship you. Say, God Almighty.
God Almighty, Lord of glory.
back to the top. Come on, say, God Almighty.
God Almighty, Lord of glory, Lord, we worship you.
Come on, say, God Almighty.
All of the praise,
we worship
the King.
Say all Say, Lord,
Lord, I give you my heart.
Talk to him. Say,
I give you my soul.
I live for you.
I live for you alone. Every breath that I take.
Every moment I'm away.
Every moment I'm away.
Have your way with me, Lord.
Have your way.
Lord, I give you my heart. Let me hear the audience. Say, Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul.
I give you my soul.
I live for you.
I live for you alone. Every breath that I take.
Every moment I'm awake.
Every moment I'm awake.
One more time, Lord, I give you my heart.
Lord, I give you my heart.
Oh.
I give you my soul.
For you I live.
I live for you alone. Every breath that I take. Every moment I'm away.
Have your way.
Have your way.
God Almighty, Lord. Church. Say, God Almighty. One more time. Say, God Almighty. Lord of glory.
Lord, we worship you.
One more time. Say, God Almighty. Oh, 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 oh Come on and give the Lord a hand, praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It's prayer time. It's prayer time. And all those who would like to come to the altar, please make your way down. Just to give you thanks and praise for bringing us safely through another week. Father, we thank you for the power of prayer. We thank you for the many answered prayers. And we also thank you for the many that you did not answer for our good. Father, we thank you for the privilege of coming before you. And we can come with expectations because you promise that you will hear us. You promise that you will answer and you promise that you will heal. But we have to confess our sins. And you who are faithful and just to forgive sins, not only forgives us, but cleanses us from all unrighteousness. Father, I thank you for giving us a Sabbath day. Father, it has been a journey all week for some of us. But being here today, Lord, we just want to say thank you for the Sabbath. We thank you for the students who have graduated from this church. Father, you have done the children much good. We thank you, Father, for the parents and all the sacrifices they make so that your children can go to school and have the awesome privilege of an education. Father, we thank you for providing for us employment. No matter the crucibles or the challenges we face on some of these jobs, we thank you that we still have jobs, we still have an income. We thank you for those who don't have a job, but you provide abundantly above they can ask or imagine. Father, you have been faithful, and we just want to say thank you for your faithfulness unto us. Father, before I petition your throne, I just ask of you that you will plunge me in your fountain with your blood, Jesus, so that I will be clean. Wash me and make me white as snow. And if there is anything, any wicked ways in me, Lord, please cleanse me from every sin and set me free, because, Father, I have many people to petition your throne for today. And I want to know that I am right before you, because, Father, I'm expecting you to hear me. And I'm expecting answers for these individuals. Some have had these challenges for too long, and it's high time for your people to be set free from whatever it is that they're going through. And so I lift up Brother Shelman Lewis, Sister Patricia Stoddart, Mr. Clive Stoddart, Sister Owls, Leah Chase, Sonia Mountain, the Langston family, Elder McGinnis, Sister Squire, Brother Wayne Jones, Craig Housen, Shanika Malcolm, Beatrice Locke, Paige Harrison, Sister Armel, the church renovation projects that you are doing a wonderful work with, Lord. We have remained in the kitchen and the fence. But you who have fixed this roof and fixed the flooring, we know you will finish the work that you have allowed to start, because it's for your good, for your cause, for your house. We lift up Sister Gertie Stewart, Maria Caban, Sister Woods, and the Long Island Area Evangelism Series. I lift up those at the altar today, Lord. Some might need employment, some also need healing, or whatever else it is, but they're at your throne, asking, petitioning, Lord, you, and on their behalf, I present these your children. Heavenly Father, I know you're a healer, because I'm standing here today. I know you are a provider, because I'm standing here today. I know you are a miracle worker, because I'm standing here today. So, Father, I am coming on behalf of your people, not because of what someone told me, but because I'm a living witness of anything you're going through, that God is able to do abundantly above all they can ask or imagine. So, Father, there is healing, because you are no respecter of persons. And you have healed me, so I know you can heal those who are sick. Father, I pray for anyone else with immigration situation. You have done it for me. You have done it for Brother Owusu. You have done it for Sister Mills. Father, you have done it over and over again for your children who have immigration issues. So, Father God, we know you're in the business of giving status adjustment to your children. So I'm asking you, dear Jesus, to do that too. Father, I pray for our widows and widowers. Father, I pray for those who are mourning, like Brother Mendez. I pray for the Perez family at work, who this man passed away yesterday. Father, this man wanted to be around just for his daughter's wedding, and she will not have her father to walk her down the aisle. So I ask you to comfort the Perez family with only the comfort that comes from you, when the loss and the grief is so great. And I know you're a comforter because you have done it for me. Father, I thank you for what you did for the doctor, NK. You brought her safely through that surgery. And so, Father, I praise you for that. And I pray that if she doesn't know you, that she will come to know that her healing did not come by the wisdom of her colleagues, but it came by the prayers that went upon her behalf. And through this experience of healing, may Dr. NK come to know you, the great physician. Father, I pray for the spirituality of us, your children. Father, you're at the door, and some are still trotting the fence. And we just come before you today asking, Father, that you will just come up in our experiences. And whatever it is that is preventing that full allegiance to you, Lord, that you will remove it in a mighty way, O Father. Jesus, you're coming soon, and we need to be ready. Father, none of us know what later holds, much more tomorrow. And we want to know that when our eyes are closed, that the next face we will see and the next voice we will hear is yours coming forth in the first resurrection. So I'm asking you, dear Jesus, to save us, your people. Help us to stop kidding with our salvation. Any indifferences among us as people of God, help us to lay it aside and let brotherly love, sisterly love continue in the household of faith. Father, I ask you to come in the midst of this church, O God, and fix the mess that brews, O Lord. You know that. You know the messes, Lord. Fix it, O God, so that we, your children, can have the victory that we need in our lives when the people of God are right before the God of heaven. Father, I lift up the man speaker today. Father, you have used him before, and we're asking you to use him one more time. We need a word from you, Lord, a word that is fitting for such times as these. So I'm asking you, dear Jesus, to speak through your manservant. Do for us what we are not able to do for ourselves, so that at the end of this day, we will not be the way we came in, and we can truly have that experience with you, our God. Because, Jesus, we need to be ready for you to come. Father, if there is anything or anyone I fail to petition, may you, O Father, who knows everything about every one of us, may you intercede in the lives, go in the lives of that individual or those individuals, so that they can see your awesome power and glory revealed. We give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, and we give you all the praise. And Father, we wait. Our eyes are upon you today because we're expecting something from you. So speak, Lord, through your servant. Speak, Lord. Your people listens. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, Church. Our special music and meditation once again will be given to us by one of Bethesda's vibrant youth, Shino Asker.
Happy Sabbath.
Thank you.
Yes, beautiful. How great thou art. Thank you, dear sister. It's time for us to bring our tithe and offering to the Lord as being faithful servants. The whole week, God has been good to us. So he wants us to return the tithe and offering. So whilst the deacon and deaconess are collecting the tithe and offering, I want you to open your Bibles and open Malachi 3, verse 7. I'm reading something from there. It says, robbing God of his offerings. Even from the days of your fathers, ye are gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, says the Lord of hosts. But ye said, wherein shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even his whole nation. So I want you to think about yourself and ask yourself, am I being faithful to the Lord? Or do I have to do a certain changes in my life to become a good, faithful Christian? Whether we like it or not, God expects us to return our tithe and offering. We should not come to church with empty-handed, because God's work has to go on around the world. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now, hear it, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. We give thee, burden whole, whatever is may be, all that we have is thine, O Lord, our trust, O Lord, from thee. Amen. Let's pray. Most gracious Lord, we thank you, we honor you. You are such a good God, and you have done marvelous to us. We bring this offering to you to bless it and use it in honor of your glory. But bless everybody. And if somebody is here going through some difficulties, financial difficulties or job issues, Lord, intervene and provide all of them jobs and finance. May your name be praised and may your name be glorified. We thank you and we honor you. We thank you and we glorify your name. Amen. We have to collect the building fund. You heard it that we have to finish the kitchen and we have to put fence around the house of God. So we have to do it. So we should not be tired of putting out money for God's work. So whether dollar, $100, $200, any, even 10,000, yes. Feel free from your heart. God is going to bless you. Yes, every day of my life I am blessed.
When I wake up in the morning and I lay my head to rest, every day of my life I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. Every day of my life I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning, when I lay my head to rest, every day of my life I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am blessed. Every day of my life I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning, when I lay my head to rest, every day of my life I am blessed.
Did I miss anybody? Anybody? All right, let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for all you have done. I want to thank you for your many blessings you bestowed upon us, dear Father. Thank you for giving us jobs, dear Father, that we were able to give, that we may be able to complete and beautify your temple. Thank you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Happy Sabbath, Church. Today's scripture reading will be taken from Daniel chapter 3, 18 through 25. Please stand. But if not, be it known unto thee, O King, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake, and commanded that they should heat the furnace 17 times more than it was wont to be heated. And he commanded the most mighty men that were in his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their coats, their hosen, and their hats, and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king commandment was urgent, and the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound in the midst of burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished, and rose up in haste and spake, and said unto his counselors. Did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, True, O king. He answered and said, Lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt, and the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Let us hear another amen for Pastor Bensi. Amen. That is our future pastor. Amen. He's anointed and appointed. We want to thank God for his parents who is training him up the right way. For the Bible said, train a child in the way that he should go, and when he or she got older, they would not depart. Amen. We thank God for Brother Bensi and his parents and his family. Brother Uzu, keep up the good work, man. God is good. Amen. Today we are blessed to have Pastor Fitzroy, Elder Fitzroy Baxter, that is, worshiping here with us today. I ask him, what do you want me to say about you? Elder Baxter, he simply turned to me and said, Elder Brown, I'm just a servant of the living God. And that touched me. We ought to be like Elder Baxter, a servant of the living God. Amen? We are blessed to have him and his beautiful wife today, Sister Baxter. What's the first name? Marcia, could you just stand and wave to the church, Sister Marcia? Hallelujah, amen, amen. And I was sitting next to Elder Baxter, and I look at his shoes, and I said, this brother have a wonderful, beautiful pair of shoes. And I remember it took me to the scripture that says, oh, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good tidings. And Ella, I know that you have a word for us today, because you bring tidings from the Lord. But before you do so, we're going to hear from Sister Oscar again, and after Sister Oscar have bring us our ministry by music, the next voice you're going to hear is the voice of Elder Baxter here, Amen? Amen? God bless your heart. Keep him in prayer as he minister to us. And who is in the song room? Would you like to have a different mic for Elder? You got it? Oh, my God. All right, so.
Stay up.
Testing. Let the church say amen. Amen. Pray on. I want to thank our dear, beloved, young, beautiful singer. Let the church say amen one more time. Amen. It's good to see young people in the church of God. Amen. Nowadays, a lot of them don't go to church. Thank God for those who came by and is dedicated to the service of the Lord. I just want to say also to the young man that read the scripture, that the parents keep up the good work. In these last days, we need some soldiers. And these are future for our church. I've been to many churches and there is no young people. So when you find few that is interested in doing something for the Lord, encourage them. You know, we like to correct them when they're wrong, but when you see something good, help build them up. Many years ago, in 1985, when I came to the church, I didn't know I could do nothing in church. But the first elder for the church saw something in me that I did not know I have in me. And he encouraged me. And then when the first elder was going out, he was an evangelist, right? And brand new in the church, he started to take me with him. And give me the opportunity to share the word of God. Sometimes I couldn't even call the word, even though today I still have a problem with some of the words. Amen, somebody? And he used to help me. And in life, if you see a young people with certain ability, look at it and help them to become better. And your church will be better, because when the older one, we passed away, the church will keep on going. I want to say this church have a wonderful praise team. Let me hear somebody say amen. Timothy and the team, our brother who sing. One thing I like about we, when you do something for Jesus, put yourself in it. If you're selling something and I see that you don't really like it, I'm not going to buy it if you're not selling the thing like you don't like the thing. You got to show that you are in what you are doing. So when it comes to God, put yourself in it. I want to thank everyone who participate in the program today, and the prior, the scripture reading. Elder Brown, thank you for your kind words. And I am standing in for your pastor, Pastor Jackson, today. And I'm asking God to lead me. I want to thank God for my little soldier, my prayer warrior, my wife, my friend. We are soldiers in the army of the Lord. Thank you for coming with me. Today, I want to say to God be the glory, I came here on business not to do my own thing, but I came to represent the Lord. And when you truly want to represent the Lord, you can't do your own thing. Sometimes you come with something and the power of the Holy Spirit have something else. You have to let the Holy Spirit move. And I'm not ashamed to say I'm a Seventh-day Adventist, but when the Spirit of the Lord move, I'm not too dignified to say hallelujah. When you know where the Lord has brought you from, when you think of how you have been put down, how you have been sick, and how the Lord lift you up, I'm not ashamed to say hallelujah. Some people come to church like they vex, but even if I'm vexed, when I come to church, I'm blessed. For the Bible says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be what? Be thankful unto him. And then what? For the Lord is good. So even if things wasn't good for me this week, I'm still alive. So I came to praise the Lord. Do you know COVID could have killed a lot of us? A matter of fact, some of us can testify that COVID jumped on us. But it's the grace of that God that kept us. Amen, somebody. When you see that you're alive, make up your mind, for the rest of my life, I will give God praise. But there is none like him. There is none next to him. I want to just tell you something that happened before I jump into the word. I just also want to welcome everyone online. If you are on Zoom, welcome. Always feel free and always come online, for when you come to Centralites, you'll get a blessing. If you are on YouTube, welcome. If you are on Facebook, welcome. For there is no place when God, like when God is in the place. If God is in the place, you will be blessed. So welcome on all platforms in Jesus' name. I want to share something that I find happened this week with you. So you see, I'm going to share the word of God, but let me tell you what happened. I get a lot of calls this week, but one of them that was so funny, I got a text, and the text said, we have a lot of children. We have a lot of children that don't have parents from a foreign country. And sir, because I go on Facebook and YouTube, I have messages up there. And because you are in your jacket sometimes, people think you're rich, right? Because you are in a jacket, but they don't know you could be in a jacket, but poor. Because I went to look a job, and I was in a jacket. I didn't even have money to take the bus when I was in a jacket. So the person say, we have a lot of poor children over here in this country. And we're asking you to help support these children. And I was thinking, I say, you know, my wife is not currently working. She need a car. I can't even buy it. So I told the person, I do give, but I am not able to give to everybody. And I have sisters and brothers. My parents have 11 children. And there are some of them that need help. Now, some of us, we love to help everybody else except our own, right? So I told the person, I am not able to help all these children. You know what they text back and say? Be careful, you are in America taking money to be your idol. I say, well, I don't do that, and I help who I can, but I can't help everybody. What's amazing is that some people think because you're in the United States of America that you have everything. Yes, we have Jesus. And I say to the person, I am sure in the word of God, if the Lord should have blessed me with a blessing that could overflow, one day you could get some of it. But I'm not going to try to impress you. I'm not going to rob a bank to try to prove to you that I'm a child of God. Because some people think it's what you give. It's what in your heart. Because the woman that went to church didn't have a lot. But Jesus says she was blessed because she gave her best. So when you give your best, that's what matters. I thank God. Today, the topic the Lord dropped in my mind, entitled Loose in the Fire. Loose in the fire, and today I want to show you that you can be free and not in prison, but yet still you are tied up. You can be free walking up and down, but you're tied up because of some financial or some sickness or some problem. But today I want to show you, we serve a God that have power to take what meant to block you, to stop you, to cripple you. This devil sent things to paralyze you, but God of the power to set somebody free. Oh, Lord, let me pray because I want to get into the word of God. Dear God, let the words of my mouth. I came here today. The people didn't come to see me. They came to hear a word. So, God, remove Baxter and let your name be glorified. Remove Baxter and let the Holy Spirit take control. And I'll be careful to give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Loosen the fire. The text was so well read by our little preacher that I will just read one verse from Daniel chapter 3. It's a well-known story, so I don't have to, but I just want to read one verse, verse 15 of Daniel chapter 3. Verse 15 said, "Now if he be ready at what time he hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kind of music, he fell down and worshipped the image which I have made." Well, notice what the king is saying. If you do what I say, well. In life, you're going to meet a lot of people that they will say, if you follow what I say, well. If you obey me, well. But watch this. When I was going to school, they say, when you see the word but, he say, if you do this, well. But if you don't do this, I'm going to tell you something. He said, but if he worship not, he shall be cast the same hour into the midst of what, church? A burning fiery furnace. And watch the question he said. Now he said, and who is that God that shall deliver thee, deliver you out of my hands? Somebody need to know that you are going through today, but God wanted to know right now that your life is not in a man's hand. Your life is not in a woman's hand. Your life is in God's hand. Now on the job, you're going to meet some people that act like your life is in their hands. They act like they you could get a promotion because you've been there for long. And some sort of boss acting like your future is in their hands. But I want to tell you that when you pray to God, God can let the boss understand that you got to be careful because God will allow them to get fire sometime and you stay higher. Your life is not in people's hands. And so in the Bible, we see the story of Shadrach, who Meshach, and Abednego. It's a well-known story. We see that, number one, these men was in a strange land. Many of us say, I used to be on fire for the Lord. So what happened now? Why you stop being on fire for the Lord? Is it because of COVID? Well, you could still be a blessing in COVID. Am I right, somebody? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego went to a different place, but they maintained their Christianity. They stand up for God. Some people only be Christian on Sunday and on Sabbath. Some people on the Sabbath day, they are so holy. Oh, hallelujah. Happy Sabbath. But some of them, as the sermon finished, they start to gossip. Because in every church, I notice there's two group of people. You have both groups start with W. You have the worshipers, and then you have the watchers. The watchers come to watch what's not right. They're looking for faults, or they're looking for something to complain about. The art didn't match the top, and the shoes didn't match that. That's the watchers. But I don't know which group you're in, but I'm in the group that come to praise the Lord. Even if you don't like me, it's too bad for you because I'm coming back next week because I just came to what? Praise the Lord. You got some people, if they go to church and they have a new hairstyle and you didn't tell them it looked nice. They vex, you know. But in life, you got to get to the place that you're looking to God for his blessing, not to people. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were living in Babylon. They were living in a strange place, and they got a job working with the king. But they maintained their what? Their Christianity.
How many people get jobs, and after they get the promotion, after they get the degrees, after they achieve certain things, they what? They forget about God. When they were going to school, they were praying to God to help them to pass the test. And if you are honest, sometimes you didn't study so well. And while you are in the test, you say a little prayer, and God help you to pass the test. And you come out now, graduate, being one of the best, and you forget God who helped you to pass the test. So when you speak now, you're talking about based on my achievement, based on what I have attained and acquired, and mention nothing about the Lord who came through for you in the nick of time. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they maintained their integrity. The kings set up an image, and he said, you should worship this image. But when you study the Bible in Exodus, you know we shouldn't worship no image. So they knew that, and when the king said, everybody should bow down, these three men stood up for God. But as they stood up, ladies and gentlemen, somebody that should be bowing down, since they was working with the king, they start to watch. And they went to the king and said, these three men did not bow down. These three men did not show respect to you. And the king said, all right, bring them to me. Now, let me tell you this, my brothers and sisters. In life, not everybody that is looking for you, not everybody who is checking about you is looking for your best interest. Can I say that again? Not everybody that is searching for you, are checking for you, is looking out for your best interest. And so these men who report Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, their purpose was to get rid of them. Why? Because they know that the king loved them. In life, some people break up good friendships because they tell one person something that you say that you didn't say. And some people didn't bother to ask you. They just believe what they heard. And you're saying, why they behave that way with me? I don't understand. There's a coldness. And some people don't check if it's true. And so what I like about Nebuchadnezzar, he's better than some of us. He said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, come here. He said, is it true that you didn't do this? Now, a lot of us, we don't do that. We just say, well, I can't believe he did that. Yeah? But Nebuchadnezzar said, is it true that you did not worship the golden image? And he said, all right, they might be lying on you, so I will give you a second chance. He said, now, since you didn't do it then, now, if he be ready, when you hear all type of stuff, now, be careful of a lot of instrumental stuff. When you go in store, you know why they play stuff? Is to get you in a certain mood. Now, this worship service with Nebuchadnezzar have a lot of stuff going on there. He got dulcimer. He got psaltery. There's a lot of stuff. And the three young men said, there is no need to play that. We already make up our mind. We will not serve the golden image. Can I tell you something today? There is a time coming when you will have to make a decision. Brothers and sisters, as I stand here, I want to let you know some of the things that are cheap that you're buying today, the price is going to go up. Let me tell you, some of the stuff that you take out a little money to pay for, watch it, the price is going to go up. You're going to face a time that you're going to have to rely on God like never before. Now, if you don't start to practice to get close to God, you can't wait till everything turns bad. You better get a relationship now with God. Now, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego already have a relationship. Before they go to Babylon, they already have a relationship with God. So when the king tell them to worship, they already know how to worship. So you have to understand that not every worship is giving God praise. Not everybody said Jesus is for Jesus. And so Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stood for God. Now, can I tell you this? In life, what looked like defeat can turn into a blessing. In life, what look like will be a met. God have the power to take something that look messed up, and God can flip it around. He's a potter. He can remake it. Sometime what look like the situation look like there is no hope, God can turn it around. Can I give you an example of why I know God can do this? Job's life got messed up when he lost everything, lost his health and his wealth, and God flip it around and give him 7 times more blessing. Huh? David was a man that in his situation faced a situation that make him look like he would never win. If you was a gambler, you wouldn't bet on David. But can I tell you something? In life, hope brings victory when no one expects you to win. Many of you can testify, when you decide to go back to school, somebody say you must be a fool. Huh? You don't have the mindset. You don't have the mental capacity. But when you know God, God can take your mind and surprise the world. God can let somebody who barely can speak become awesome, because God specializes in using simple people to become champions. And the story with Goliath, who win? Not the big mouth. Who win? Not the one with the sword. Who win? Not the one who have the best resume. Because what was so funny about David's story? He have no resume. But Saul told David that Goliath's resume is long. He's fighting from he was a boy. He's fighting and he said to David, what is your resume? David have nothing to show. How many times have you gone on job and people look better than you? People have better resume than you, but the Holy Spirit touched the person doing the interview and say, you see that person? Choose the person. The person who dress up and have the better resume, surprise how they choose you, because when God give you favor, no resume can beat that. No resume can beat that when God give you favor. And what was so surprised? The people of God is testifying for the enemy that the enemy have better resume. And David could have said, well, a couple of years ago, I was taking care of daddy's sheep. I don't have no resume where I fight before. But you know, one day a bear came and I take care of the bear. And one day a lion came and I take care of the lion. And somebody laughed and said, the big man Goliath is not no bear. But David said, the same God that took care of the bear, the same God that took care of the lion, this same God have the power, and today he's going to take care of the big man. And what I like about David, who nobody expect to win, when Goliath get vexed and said, I wish I thought they would have sent somebody looking better. I thought they would have sent somebody with a spear and a shield. David says, sir, you come to me with a spear and a shield, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, because there is power in the name of the Lord. Not any old power, but wonder working power in the name of Jesus. In our time we are living, I'm telling you that there is still power in Jesus' name. What look like a mess, what look like with you, you turn out to be a loser. God can use the same situation and make you become a winner. And sometimes that's how the world know you. Nobody know about David. He was just there taking care of sheep. But when God get ready to promote you, the world would know that you serve a God. And so loosing the fire is to tell you that all of us go through something. And the word loose carried the implication that you must have been tied up. Mm-hmm. You must have been tied up for somebody to loose you up. And in life, that's why, notice in the text, the king said in verse 15 of Daniel 3, who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand when I put you in the fire? That's where the king go wrong. You can talk about me, but when you talk about the God we serve, you are putting yourself in trouble. Who is that God that shall deliver you? I tell you a story. I was working at a job one time, many years ago, and the job was paying $250 a week. Somebody saying, what? That's what I work a day? The job was paying $250 a week. And they say to me, for you to become a staff member, sir, you are a casual worker,
You just need to come to work one Sabbath. One Sabbath. And so when Friday come, brothers and sisters, and I'm going home, the boss said, see you tomorrow. I didn't quarrel with the boss. I say, okay, sir. When tomorrow come, I'm in church, Rock of Ages, clay for me. Let me hide myself in thee. And I go back to work Monday morning. Hear the boss now. What happened Saturday? I was in church. But guess what? Because when you're a Christian and a child of God, you can't be lazy. So when I go to work, I do my work. So even though I don't come on the Sabbath day, he knows this is a worker. I'm not going to fire him for the one day. Because when he come, he work. You don't go to work late trying to leave early. Or go to work and then trying to steal by taking some tissue and all that. You got to be a true worker. That means if you don't go to work, they miss you. And one day, the boss son dropped me home and giving me a counsel. Hear what the boss son said to me now. Mr. Baxter, I'm going to do you a favor. I said, what is that, sir? He said, come one Sabbath, and I'm going to do you a favor. I'm going to make you work till 12 o'clock, half day. And after you work half day, you don't have to come back any time on another Saturday. I said, boss, I love the job, but I can't come on a Saturday. I never go there on a Saturday. So they never put me on staff, but they never fire me. I still get $250. But can I tell you something? They were offering me, if I come one Saturday, I'm going to get $150 more per week. I would have got $400 per week. But watch this. I never get the $150, but God bless the $250. God bless the $250. God bless it and stretch it. And when I get ready to come to Great America, the best recommendation I get was from the job. Because in life, you have to learn to stand up. You can't be a wishy-washy, weak Christian. Any old wind blow your way. Let me tell you, it is said in life, any old dead fish can swim downstream. But there comes a time you have to be a true Christian that swim upstream. Because sometime in your life, you will have to swim up against tongue-talking, church-going, good-looking people in church. Let me tell you, sometimes when you come to church, if you're not careful, somebody says something that you don't want to come back next week. But when you know who bring you in the church, when you know who bring you to the Lord, when you know who hire you, you know they can't fire you. And that's why Baxter have a text, you can't find it in the Bible. Don't look in there. There's a text God give me that dwell with me all my life. He said, Baxter 3, verse 5. He said, who God hire, no man fire until God ready for you to retire. So take your burdens to the Lord in prayer. Don't look for that in the Bible. So all my life, when I go through my stuff and my trouble, and they try to fire me, I just laugh. I know who hire me. And so you can't fire me. So in the trials of life, I have some good jobs. And when they say come on the Sabbath, I tell you the last job and the job that I currently have right now, I trained for 6 weeks. And after they finished training me, because it was a holiday, a labor day, they say come make up for the Saturday. Come make up on it was a holiday. So they say come on Saturday to make up for the day. They had a brother who is a 7 day, went, let me look bad. And I tell you, I could remember today as a child of God. I remember the next day, I told the woman, and they didn't know I was a religious liberty leader in the church. So I told the lady, they said they don't discredit you or go against you by race or what? Religion. And I leave a letter from the church, and I went to a church to preach. I remember the church today. The church name is Cornerstone. The topic I preached was from brokenness to blessing. I was on the pulpit. I said, they are looking for me in the Bronx today, but if a job is for me, it is for me. And I live to testify that they called me on the Monday and said, Mr. Baxter, since you didn't come on the Saturday, you better come on a Tuesday. And he had a brother that went on the Saturday. When he come to days off, his days off was Tuesday, Wednesday. But when it come to Mr. Baxter, it was Friday, Saturday. When you stand for God, God will stand for you. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were standing for God. And while they were standing for God, the king get vexed, because some people get vexed when you don't do what they say.
Some people get vexed if they recommend a man for you. And you say, no, I don't want to talk to that man. They vex. Huh? And wish you find somebody to beat you. And wish you find somebody that wouldn't love you. Some people, if you don't do what they say, they vex. The king get vexed because the children of God didn't want to worship the image. And so they heated the fire 7 times more. Now, the regular fire could have killed the people. Now, why they eat up the fire? They figure, while the pressure come on, you're going to bend and bow. Hmm? But a child of God, it don't matter if rain falling. It don't matter if you don't have food to eat. It don't matter who forget you. It don't matter who left you. It don't matter who don't love you. Once you know Jesus love me, this I know, you will keep standing in the name of Jesus. And so Nebuchadnezzar get vexed till the fire get hot, that the people who took up the child of God get burned up. Watch this. In life, don't let people tell you if you got trouble people. Some people are telling you to go trouble people and them not troubling the person, for they're afraid of the person. But they tell you to go trouble the person and then you die. Look at this. The three men who pick up the children of God. Now watch this. These three men must be what I call, they must look like buff with the stuff. Big and thick, going to the gym every day, and the child of God just look regular. And you come and you tie them up and lift up the children of God and put them in a fire. Be careful of a child, a woman that love God. Be careful of a man that serve God. You will get yourself in trouble. You lifting up a child of God, put the child of God in a fire with the intention to kill a child of God, and God up in heaven looking, the three men who picked them up die from the heat of the fire. Now, I wasn't there, so I was wondering what killed them. And it's like the Lord brought it to me that the heat in the fire already know that God was in the fire. But the heat saw God in the fire, and the heat was running out of the fire. And while the heat was running out of the fire, he ran into the enemies and killed them. And the three men, the Christian, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego, the Bible said, the little preacher read and said, they were cast in the fire bound. Now, why the Bible said bound? This word bound means to restrict. This word bound means to contain. There are some people who want to control you. There are some people, if you could always beg them stuff, they love you. But when God start to bless you, they don't like you. All of a sudden, they don't like you. When you didn't have a job, they love you. But when God starts to bless you, they're talking about you get bigoted and you don't do a thing. For some people don't like when you get blessed. They like when you have to come to them. Mm? But you see, God is an awesome God. I like how God works. The king said, if you don't do this, you're going to get that. And so here is it. The men who pick them up, they die by the door. So the miracles start by the door. But the children of God who serve God, whether things are good, whether COVID, whether no COVID, whether no job. Some of us don't have job, but you still serve God. Can I get a witness here? Some of us, you don't have a job, but you still have a shoes on your feet. You have something to eat. You're still, God still provide for you. You are in the fire, but nobody know. You come to church, you are going through, but nobody know. Because when you come to church, you enter into his gate with thanksgiving and into its courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Because guess what? I don't have stuff for later. But the old song say, I know the Lord will make a way somehow. I may not be able to tell you when he's going to make a way. I may not be able to tell you how. But I know the Lord will make a way somehow. You can testify. Somebody here have been sick. Somebody here have been sick. And the doctor say you wouldn't last. Somebody here have experienced a family member who have been sick. And they thought you would have dead. And some of them came to the hospital and saw you. Some of the family who love cheap stuff. Already planning your funeral. Huh? For you rich, you have this. They hear them in their mind. I'm going to get the stove. I'm going to get this. I'm going to get that. And God bust up their plan by letting you live. God cancel your funeral. And you didn't die when you know that the Lord did that for you. And nobody know how sick you were. And God heal you. When you come to church, don't be ashamed to say hallelujah. They may think you're crazy, but you know what the Lord has done for you. Somebody had an accident that could have killed you. The car get damaged and God saved you. The devil almost destroyed your family and God kept you. Nobody know, but because you know, you're going to say hallelujah. Let them think you're crazy. Nobody like you know what the Lord has done for you. And so Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they stood for God, and the men decided to took them up. They died. So one thing I'm going to say again, don't let nobody let you trouble people. Be careful of who you're troubling. But notice the king didn't die. The one who tell them to tie them up did not die. But those who took them up, they died. Now let me get into the meat of the story. I'm going to wrap it up now. Watch the meat of the story. After they cast into the fire, the king said, the fire is burning, and look, the three men who died, they not even care. But nobody was frightened. I said, oh my God, they died, they didn't even care. The king was looking while the fire was burning. Now in your life, there is a fire burning. Somebody see you here, but there's a fire burning. Somebody have been stuck in the mud, a sickness that's not going away. God is saying to you, I have the power, and I see your tears, and I know your fears, and I will come true for you when the right time comes. Your fire, there is a fire, but you come to God with praise, because when the praises goes up, the blessings come down. When the praises goes up, doors open. When the praises goes up, chains fall off. God is able. And so here is the three men in the fire. Now remember, they put three men in the fire. So the scripture reading by the little preacher said, the king started to look and he said, didn't we cast three men in the fire? What did they say, church? True, O king. And the king said, we cast three men in the fire, but what? Because remember, when the word but comes, the thing gonna change. The person that is a loser now gonna become a winner. God gonna change thing. He said, but I saw four men, and notice he's testifying, the enemy's testifying. He said, they are loose in the fire and they have no hurt. They are in trouble, but you don't know because they're not crying to you. You don't know what they're going through. They still come to praise the Lord. The king said, they have no hurt. So watch this. When I come to church, I don't come with long mouth. Yes, things did not my way. I come to church like I vexed with everybody. You come to church with a joy. A joy. Because this joy I have, nobody give it to you. So nobody can take it from you. I may not have money like you, but I have a peace that you didn't give me. And when God give you this peace, nobody can take it from you. So in your Christian life, when you go through the fire, remember who hire you. Remember who call you. So watch this. He said, I see four men in the fire. And he said, but the fourth one, look, look like the who? What church? The son of who? God. Don't remember, Jesus didn't come yet. How the king know about the son of God? Lord have mercy. Do you know how the Holy Spirit work? There was nothing about Jesus, but Nebuchadnezzar said, the fourth one, look like the son of God. Now somebody here can testify, when you was in the sick room, it was the fourth man that came in the room. When you was going through your trials, it was the fourth man. When you have been put down, dragged in the sand, when they talk your name like you didn't exist, when you experience agitator, when you experience the dirt chores, when you experience the underminders, the fourth one comfort you. And the fourth man in the fire, now watch this, they were tied up, and the word loose, let me just spend a little time on this word. This word loose means you are detached. This word loose means you are separated. So something was holding you, but now you are separated from what is holding you. Now you are set free. When you are restricted, it's because they don't want you to go forward. Because they know you have a attitude of gratitude. They restrict you because they know that you will get your dream come true. They restrict you because they know you couldn't become the next boss. So they don't want to give you the promotion. Even in church, I see that. Some people have ability and talent, but they restrict you because you might become the next pastor. They restrict you and they don't like you. You might become the first elder. So they restrict you. You can sing and they know you can sing, but they restrict you because you might get too popular. You see, when you're bind up and tied up, is to stop you from going forward. And so they tied up the children of God. But watch this. When God have his blessing on you, no ropes can hold you. No chain can control you. How do I know that? Paul and Silas was preaching for God and they beat them and put them in prison. And watch this. They tie them up and the Bible said Paul and Silas was singing to God. What looked like a mess turned out to be a blessing. The Bible said they were singing and giving God praise. When you go through your trouble, brothers and sisters, give God praise. When nobody care, give God praise. Sing whole song like Blessed Assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a... Come on. Have glory divine. And if you don't know that one, you say, pass me not. And guess what? If you can't sing it, just say, pass me not. Oh, gentle Savior, hear my humble cry. While many good Christians are calling, Dr. Jesus, do not pass me by. And if you're a singer, say, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know, Lord, if you're a good singer. And then you can say, what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Sing, Paul and Silas was singing. And the Bible said when it get to midnight, it said at midnight, there was a mighty earthquake. So I wasn't there. So I was wondering, maybe this song sounds so sweet. And God was up in heaven tapping his feet. And a mighty earthquake. And the Bible said every man band were loose. Watch this. When God bless your people around, you will be blessed. When God bless you, the people that surround you will see that it's the Lord God with you. How do I know that? Joseph, the Bible said he was living in a house and everything in the house was blessed. If you go work for a job and you're a blessing, the people you work for will get a blessing because of you. You know why many people, don't, family don't destroy? It's because of you who serve God. Because when the blessings of the Lord is on you, it will go on the others around you too. So finally, in the story, the king, God allowed the king to see him as the fourth one. What is our Christian life? Our testimony is to let the world know that God lives. And so Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, God let the king saw him. Nobody told him there was a fourth man in the fire. The king himself said, I saw a fourth man in the fire. Why? Because God wanted him to know, watch your mouth. When you talk about who is this God that shall deliver you, I am the fourth man. I am the fourth one in the fire. You run your mouth like there is no God, but I'm letting you know I'm still God, and I still sit on the throne. Somebody saying, well, if you're a Christian, how you end up in a slavery? If you're a Christian, how you're not rich? If you're a Christian, how you get sick? Let me tell you, bad things can happen to good people. So God showed them that I am the God that can deliver them. And hear the king now. Oh, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now, he's talking loud. He's a king. He should be talking, you know, intelligent. But he's talking loud. He said, oh, servant of the Most High God, come forth. And he said, come forth. Now, watch this. He's shouting in front of everybody, a king shouting. Saying, come forth, he's servant of the Most High God. And then when they came forth, here, the Bible said, they examined them. When God bless you, people want to know how you become blessed. When you was suffering, they don't call you for the thing. You go beg money. You know? But when you have stuff, none of them call you. Now they're ringing down your phone. When they came out of the fire, they examined them. And hear what the people said. Not even a smell of smoke is upon them. Sometime when you go through your water, your flood and your fire, God will bless you that the world know that yes, indeed,
God is the one who deliver you. They know God is the one deliver you. For some of them was trying to get rid of you too. Some of them go to voodoo worker. But when the voodoo worker look, he must tell them, you see that man? Leave that man alone as a servant of the living God. You see that woman? You better leave her alone. And so they know that you have been with God. So when they came out, they examined them. And then hear the kingdom. There is no God like the God of Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego who can deliver like this. Watch this. If our God was a God that might come, they would have burned up. If our God that was a God that may come, they would have burned up. Church, I don't want a God that may come or might come. I want a God that shall come. But the word shall mean it must be done. As I close today, I want to let you know that they learned a lesson that day. Watch them out when it comes to God, people. Talking about who is that God. God show up in the fire. And guess what? The fire that was should kill them, guess what God did? The same fire, he flipped it around and promote them. He promote Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Watch this. If the people knew that they wouldn't have died in the fire, they would have leave them with the whole job. For they wouldn't want them to get a new job. But sometimes what meant to stop you, what meant to get rid of you, God flip it around to be a blessing in your life. So in spite of your fire today, I know you don't have everything. I know you're going through something. God sent me to remind somebody. Jesus, he see your tears and he knows what you are going through. But he wanted to know, I still have the power to loose you. I still have the power to give you a breakthrough. I still have the power to give you a break off. Trust me, in these last days, brethren, it's going to get more rough. It's going to get more tough. So learn like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Start to pray now. So when the fire come, when the storms come, you are already gripped and solid in Jesus. As you go through your trials of life, remember, there is someone who cares when nobody cares. His name is Jesus. He said in St. John's chapter 14, verse 1 to 3, he said, if I go, I will come again. Ladies and gentlemen, God said in his word in Revelation chapter 1, 21. Revelation 21, he said, there will be a new heaven and a new earth. Revelation 21, verse 21, the Bible said, you're going to walk on streets of gold. Revelation 22, verse 12, it said, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they might have right to the tree of life and enter to the gates into the city. Revelation 22, verse 17, he said, come take the water of life freely, because there is no time to wait. You don't have money to buy salvation, but come right now. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 18, say, come now. Say, let us reason together. Don't wait. There is no time to wait. 1 John chapter 1, verse 9 said, if we confess our sins, he's what? Faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all sins. As you go through today, let us live right. Because Proverbs chapter 15, verse 3 said, the eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. We could fool church people. We can't fool God. God know everything that we are doing. I want us to know this, that just because I preach can't save me. Just because you look beautiful can't save you. Just because your tide is big can't save you. Just because you drive a big car can't save you. What saves us is to be washed in the blood. And there is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's vein. And sinners like you and I can come and plunge and lose all our guilty stain. Loose in the fire. Whatever you are going through, God has the power to lose you. I tell you this in the powerful name of Jesus, the Son of God. He promised you life. He said, if I go, I will come again. Somebody online, I'm going to pray for somebody today. Spirit of God, lay heavily upon me to pray for somebody. Somebody's here today, you are going through. Whatever you are going through, but you are going through. You want to say, Lord, I thank you that even though I'm going through, that your mercy and your grace is still upon me. I should have received this grace, but thank you for your amazing grace. We have made mistakes and we deserve to be punished, but God give us grace. My brothers and sisters, the Bible said in Revelation 22, verse 11, one day he that is unjust is going to remain unjust, and he that is righteous is going to stay righteous. So let us make our choice today. Is there anybody here today before I pray who want to say, Lord, I want to follow you? If you're online today, you know you have the information. You can get in contact with the church. If you want to give your life to Jesus, you could check it out. You know, Centralized Slip SDA Church. And you could talk to somebody and they could give you further information to give your life to the Lord. Is there anybody here in the congregation who want to say, Jesus, I want to surrender to you today. I want to surrender to you today. Or is there somebody that there is a fire in your life and you want to turn it over to the Lord? Let us all stand as we pray. Sweet Holy Spirit. Sweet Holy Spirit. Oh Lord have mercy. Let us pray. Dear God, I thank you so much. I thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. I thank you for speaking to my mind. I thank you, Lord, for the truth that even though we are tied up, you have the power to loose us up. You did it for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And God, you can do it for somebody today. There is somebody that is going through a fire today. There's somebody that is going through a flood. There's somebody that's stuck in the mud. And in the name of Jesus, I ask you, dear God, to look down from heaven. Visit this person, oh God, like you visit Zacchaeus, the sinner. Oh God, come to our house, dear God, and cleanse us from sin. So when the roll is called up yonder, we can be in the number when the saints go marching in. Oh Lord, there is somebody that is living from check to check today. Bless this person with a check that will last for life. There's somebody that is sick today. And I pray, God, that you will touch that person from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. And let them be loose and be free. In Jesus' name I pray. Let the people of God say amen. Oh Lord, and amen. Amen.
Standing, please turn to page 7 at the back of the bulletin or in your hymnal, hymn 618. A very timely hymn. Stand up for Jesus.
Trust your own.
Let's pray. Most gracious Lord, we thank you for your word, and we thank you for your maid servant. Bless him and his entire family, and bless all of us. Help us to stand firm as you use Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and strengthen our faith, bind us so that we all stay in you and stand faithful in any adversity that we went through. Help us to stand firm for you, Lord, because you are our King and you are the Lord of Lords that we are waiting. Keep us all under your wings and help us to be faithful for you till the end. Bless the food that has been prepared, and let your Shekinah glory be with us all and lead us for victory and perfection. We thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Reflection. Truly, we want to thank the man of God for